This episode of DNews is brought to you by Domain.com. Dinosaur evolution seems pretty straightforward. Creepy lizardish thing to creepy raptor thing to slightly less creepy chicken. But what if evolution reversed itself? Hey everyone, Julia here for DNews. DOLLO'S law, named after 19th century paleontologist Lewis DOLLO, states that once a structure is lost in evolution, it's lost forever. But sometimes, on a rare occasion, the past pops back up. Researcher Alexander Vargas and others from the University of Chile, who analyzed modern birds, discovered one such case. They found an ancestral wrist bone may have made a comeback. The ancestors of some dinosaurs walked on all fours and needed strong wrists with 11 bones to support their weight. One of these bones is called the pisiform. When dinosaurs started walking on just two legs, the wrist changed a little bit. They weren't so good for getting around, but they were pretty good at tearing apart prey. In the change, they lost some weight and a couple of bones. This wrist had just three. The pisiform either disappeared or became so soft it left no trace in the fossil record. When dinosaurs took to flight, the wrist changed again to be a more flexible wing. These early bird-like raptors evolved a different type of wrist bone, the ulnar. To figure out the fate of the missing bone, the researchers examined evidence from both the fossil record and from the development of modern bird embryos. In developing embryos, they used a tracking technique using stains to see how the bones formed. Looking at the more modern birds, the researchers noticed that the ulnar was suspiciously present in the early stages of development, but wasn't present in the fully grown birds like previously thought. But there was a bone there in adult forms, and upon closer inspection, it was really just the missing pisiform back again. The researchers think the re-emerging bone is the result of vestigial genes. Vestigial limbs or organs, like our tailbone or appendix, are traces of the past. They are the remains of parts that are no longer evolutionarily advantageous, so they either disappear into our history or become almost useless. Over the millennia, the genes that coded for the pisiform were still there, they were just dormant. And when they were expressed again, they were no longer good for walking around on all fours, but they were great for flying. So the bone appeared, disappeared, and re-emerged to perform a different function, which is a radical concept for scientists. The idea of evolutionary reversal is still met with resistance. It goes against DOLLO'S law, which treats evolution like a one-way street. Even though several cases of reversal happening have been identified, there's the case of the South American frogs who had teeth re-emerging after 200 million years of absence. This recent research is just one piece of a puzzle that could turn one of the most closely held scientific concepts on its head. It's cool, it's weird, it's evolution. On that note, if you want your web presence to evolve, then consider buying a domain name from domain.com. No domain extension will help you tell your story like a .com or .net domain name. And because you watch DNews, you can get 15% off domain.com's name and web hosting by using the code DNews when you check out. What do you think? Can evolution reverse itself? What if one day our descendants get their tails back? Leave a comment below. And to learn more about how the dinosaur evolved into a bird, let Trace tell you in this video down here. And for more DNews, hit that subscribe button. We post new videos every day.